Welcome back. It's Hot Mail Show. It's hot.
Larry Love.
We got a little reaction video for you. We're doing a
Defecto Nemesis for Case Cody.
Yeah, Case Cody or Case Cody. It's true reaction.
I don't know who it is.
I never even heard nothing. Never heard band. So you know I ain't
it's
heard
a 3 minute
song.
Long song. So
yeah. So
hopefully it's fast and in your face.
Yes. So we'll talk a little bit more about it after it's done. Really can't really say much. In case y'all wonder, this dude's been on before. It's Love.
Yep.
He's done a couple.
Oldie but a goodie.
So he wanted to come back and we go shoot another one. So we go give his Defecto a spin. You ready to roll, Fist?
I'm
you got
ready.
Your earbud ready?
Bud. I'm ready to roll.
All right, here we go.
I feel that there's going to be some growly vocals here. Yeah, you just look at that.
This is strings kind of stuff
here. Yeah. Nope. Vocals was not what I thought it was.
He's got the Zach Wild look going on with the old beard and stance.
This is up your alley, man.
Yeah.
No, this is right up your alley. I would have rather heard some ground here vocals.
Wasn't quite what I was. I didn't know what I was expecting.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Anymore, I don't have any idea. Shredding it.
Yeah, that's what he's gonna say.
He's no slouch on the guitar.
Definitely a solid. He's got a lot of punch.
Yeah. Oh, we got another solo.
Yeah, two solos. Jeez. Back-to-back solos, man.
Those guys play lead.
We're out of the creepy house. It's a full moon.
Yeah, crazy shit's gonna happen.
Right.
Boy, that was short,
that was.
Sweet, and to the point.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't mess around on that song.
No, they didn't.
So, what'd you think of them?
I liked it. The vocals was a little bit of the, but you know, I was like, definitely when it started off, I was expecting that to be a different and a
yeah
different.
I wasn't expecting
but I liked it.
Thumbs very, up
yeah I'll give thumbs, thumbs up.
Video was just pretty much them jamming. It looked like a castle
or a sane asylum or something old and creepy in the middle of the night. The music, the bass line, I was liking the way the bass was going. I liked the way the format for the song was set up. The vocalings was a little for me, but it was very solid, like just the drum line in the song. But
as Mike May would always say, they pretty much got everything they needed done in less than 4 minutes.
Yes, yep.
And they say that's when you write a killer song, if you can get all that and two killer back-to-back solos, pretty much.
I like the two guitar solos. Like I said, one, you know, they showcased both their guitar stylists, and you know, back-to-back. So that was pretty good. And
well, and I mean, the drumming and the bass was no slouch neither. It seemed like all top-notch musicians.
Yeah, definitely good at the craft. Case, we hope you enjoyed the video on it too.
Yeah, leave comments if they're. I'm guessing they're probably not an American band. I could be wrong. I'm saying they're probably European.
Yeah, we know nothing about them. I mean, hell, they could be 20 miles from here.
Yeah. Nah, well, I don't know if they're going to be that close. But I don't think they're an American band, but that'd be a good comment section.
Fill it out. Let us know.
Yeah, let us know more about these people. I know usually our audience seems to be pretty good about, you know, giving brief little histories on the band.
Yeah.
Because some of this stuff, I mean, I thought I listened to a lot of music.
Well, there's ways. But there's, man, so much music out there.
But when we started doing this, dude, it's like I get stuff and I'm like, man, I've never even heard of this. And there's some good stuff out there.
Well, like when we just listened to that XJAPAN, you know, I figured they were like a newer band, and you know, came up around. It was from 93, so it just goes to show. I mean, 20 years prior and still, so there's just so much music out there in the world to listen to.
Yeah, I mean, I'm looking down. We've got a list of about 10 we're going to do tonight, and I'm looking through, and I might see Ferdinand King Diamond, Danzig,
Skid Row,
and Korn. You know, they ain't half of them. I mean, the only reason we know is Band-Maiden Dirt Gray is because of this.
Before, yeah, from you doing know, these, exactly.
And like me and String always says, the people out there, they love their Band-Maiden, they love their Dirt Gray. Mm-hmm. There's no doubt about that. And maybe they'd love their Defecto. I mean, I don't know.
We'll find out, man.
Yeah, I guess hit us up. Views, thumbs up. We appreciate all that stuff.
Yep, definitely.
Subscribe and ring the bells. Tell your friends. Really, I don't know if there's any more we need to say about Defecto.
If you like them, check out more of their stuff. That's the best way to.
Or hit us up if you want to see us review.
Do another one.
Yes, react to another one. Yeah, we're down with it. I guess we'll go rolling out here. This is extremely short, but I think it's because we had 3 minutes.
Yeah, 3 minute long song.
So that knocked a couple minutes off right there.
That was like a punk album.
All right, well, thanks again, Cass Cody. We're out of here. Peace.
Peace.